The mix window is laid out much like a traditional mixing console, with each track displayed as a vertical channel strip. Even though you can control your mix directly from the edit window, the mix window gives you a more intuitive control over your mix. You can see everything at a glance. Some people even prefer to track using the mix window. So let's take a look. On the left, just like in our edit window, we have our tracks list. Here you can select and hide and show tracks. And we also have menu options for this. You can show all tracks, only selected tracks, or just tracks of a specific type. And you can hide and sort your tracks. In the bottom, we have our groups list, where all of the groups that you make will show up. And we have a pop-up menu that allows you to control these. We'll talk more about the tracks list and the groups list as we progress through the course. On the bottom, we also have the same show and hide button, the mix window view selector, to show and hide the tracks and groups list. Now let's look at what we have in the mix window. Right now, we can see the track color, one of our inserts, our I/O, which shows our inputs and our outputs, our automation, the group ID indicator, our panning and pan indicators, we have record enable, solo, mute, we have our main fader, which controls the volume for the channel, and we have the meters that show the level for the channel. Beneath the fader is our audio value indicator, which shows us a numeric value of where the fader level is. Beneath that, we have our voicing, which is set to dynamic or off, or on instrument and MIDI tracks, we have our patch list selection, and a little indicator of the track type. We see a little waveform for audio tracks, a piano keyboard for instrument tracks, a MIDI connection cable for MIDI tracks, an arrow for aux buses, and a little summing symbol for the master. At the very bottom, we have a little pop-up menu that allows us to select to show or hide various elements of the mixer. We can also choose to select all or minimal. Now, you can also access these same controls under the View menu by selecting Mix Window Views. So let's go ahead and show all, and I can point out the other things that we haven't looked at in the mixer. Here we have the mic preamp section, the instrument section, we have inserts, and there's actually 10 inserts, inserts A through E and F through J. This is where you would insert plugins and virtual instruments. And you have your sends, A through E and F through J for another 10. Let's scroll down, and we can see that below the track name, we have our delay compensation view, and we have comments, and again at the bottom is our track color. And we'll cover a lot of this in more detail as we progress through the course. We can also choose to make our mixer narrow. Under the view menu, you can choose Narrow Mix, or use the key command Command-Option-M on a Mac, or Control-Alt-M on Windows, and now you can see that each channel strip is now more narrow. This is a really great feature if you have a lot of tracks in your session or if you have a really small monitor, because it allows you to see more channels in your mixer. There's one more great little feature that I want to point out, and that is that you can make the meters wider. If you hold Control, Option, and Command on a Mac, or Control, Alt, and Start on a PC, and click the meter, they all get a little bit wider. While Pro Tools only offers some of the options available in Pro Tools HD, you can see the options and change the scale by right-clicking and choosing from the pop-up menu. So here you can see that we're using the sample peak, but there are a few other options available. So another thing to note is that we can change the master meter independently of all the other track meters. So we can have the master meter be on Pro Tools Classic, while all the other meters are still on sample peak. If you want to change all of the meters to the same type, just hold Option on a Mac or Alt on Windows and select the type of meter that you want. So I'll select a different one so that we can see them all change, and you can see that we've now changed all of the meters to a different type. I'm going to go ahead and change them back to sample peak. If you're running Pro Tools HD, you can even view the gain reduction for your compression right next to the main meters. The channel strip layout of the mix window makes it fairly intuitive to use. Even if you've never used a traditional console, it won't take you long to grasp what all of the controls do. Hopefully you already have an understanding of the controls from this movie, but we'll be going over all these controls and the features in the mixer in more depth throughout the course.